What's up, comics nerds and nerdettes? Chris here, Doc and Howlett, back again to show you part whatever this is. part 9 of my entire comic book collection. So what we're going to go through today is what I have listed as my image box, plus a couple of other more independent titles, but all my Spawn comics are separate. That's going to be a separate video. I got about 2.5 boxes worth of Spawn stuff. So yes, Image and some other indies in this particular box. So let's start on this side with an interesting series right here. This is Weapon Zero. It was really interesting, you know, with aliens, alien tech, this new superhuman group, you know, that was back in the 90s, created by Image. Really cool, really interesting series. So I got the whole entire series here. So here's Weapon Zero. This is T-4. We have T-3, T-2, T-1, issue 0, and then we have issue number 1. I really like the costumes, and the artwork was just amazing. I really love this pencil work. It was some of my favorite stuff back in the 90s. Issue number 2. Three. Four. Samurai looking suit, that's cool. Five. Six. Eight, nine, ten. Apparently, it's part of Devil's Reign Interlude. 11, 12, 13, 14, and the final issue, number 15. Then here, you guys, crazy title, and this is still one title that I don't think Image has been forgiven for and answered about, and that's this Image United. This series never was completed. I don't know what happened with, you know, intercompany stuff or whatever, but this was supposed to be a huge crossover event. They started it, and then all of a sudden, I guess, things were happening in other books and probably with other artists and within the company and everything, and it just went dark. The project just never got finished. I think there was pencils for, like, a couple of more issues, but they were never published, and I've never heard any answers from the company. I've even tried emailing Image and McFarlane as well about it. There's just no answers for this, and it's really disappointing because it was going to be a pretty good event. But here we have issue number 0. Got it signed by Chris Giarrusso. And here's Image. Here's number 1. The special foily title there. Issue number 2. And there was a bunch of, I think this is part of connecting covers. All the covers were supposed to connect, but again, like I say, they never finished. Issue 3, here's a different variant cover for that one. See, so it says 3 of 6, and that's as far as it went. It says right there in the corner, 3 of 6, issue 3 is as far as they got, which was really saddening. So, like I say, I've never heard any more information on this, why they never finished it. If you guys have any information on it, let me know, because this is kind of interesting in the history, at least, of Image Comics, why that was never finished. Here, a title I would like to finish eventually. This is a pretty cool series, too. This is The Max, issue number 1. I know there's that new Maximized, where it's being republished. But these are the originals. So that's issue one. I'd love to get the glow-in-the-dark one. That'd be pretty cool. You know, Sam Keith... is it Sam Keith? I think it's Sam Keith. I know it's Keith, but I think it's Sam. Sam Keith. Max number two. Artwork's pretty good. Number three. Four. Five. There was some pretty good 90s stuff. I mean, a lot of people hate on the 90s, you know, comics. Well, at least they hate on the industry in the 90s, but there was some pretty cool stuff coming out in the 90s, too. Number six. Seven, crossover with Pitt. Eight, another one with Pitt. Nine, that one looks pretty wicked. 10. 11. And then I got some Pitt comics here. I know I have number one. It's probably hiding in a box somewhere else. So eventually I'll probably show you that. Issue two. Was it Dale Keown? Yeah. Number four. Five. Six. And then a couple of other Image books here, which these two will I'll probably sell because I have none of the others. And yeah, I'm not probably not going to find them. But here's Violator issue number two and issue number three of Violator. I'm going to say probably going to sell those. Okay, so I'll show some other independent books here and then I'll get back into some more Image titles. So let's start with this, Tales of TMNT. This is issue number 50. I started getting back into the Turtles at this time because they were going to print a story that was actually from the original Ninja Turtles Archie comics that was supposed to come after issue 72, which was the end of the series. But there was a story, I think it was called Future Tense, if I'm correct. Yeah, it had the Future Turtles and... it was going to be really awesome. I was just really into it, really looking forward to it. And it was advertised, and then it was pushed back, and then things in the company happened, I think, and it just never really got done. Really disappointing, even though there's some advertisements in the back of some of these for those books. And I made a video on that years ago. If you want to look back, you can probably look at my channel for... Look up TMNT, Archie, Future Tense. Maybe that'll probably bring it up for you. Okay, so let's go on with this. Here's issue number 50, 51, 52, and crossover with the Cowboys of Moo Mesa there. Those are really awesome. I got to get all those Archie comics too. I kind of grew up on some of those. I have a couple, but need some more of them. 59, 62, 63, 64, and 65, and then from Mirage. What were these other ones? Those are all Mirage, weren't they? Yeah. And Donatello. This is a mini series, The Brain Thief, issue 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then got this Color Classics, published by IDW, reprinting the first TMNT book. Interesting that they made this new series. I was kind of excited when it first came out. Really particularly wasn't enjoying the I don't know, the storytelling in this and changing the origins a bit and that. It just really didn't appeal to me. It wasn't didn't seem like my Ninja Turtles, but it was still cool enough, but wasn't worth my money as much. This is the gatefold one where it's got the fold out of all the different characters. Gotta put this in a new bag. Same with this one. Issue number 2, 3. So I eventually stopped collecting this particular series. Number 4, 5, 6. That's all I collected for that. And then here was an issue of the Infestation 2 because it was a Turtles crossover. I did get it. Now this is probably one of the most wicked Turtle comics you can ever read. Here's Body Count, and this basically stars Raphael and Casey Jones. If you like the original Turtles, you love just the brutality and the relationship between Casey and Raph, this is for you guys. Awesome. I really recommend it. If you're a hardcore older TMNT fan, pick up this series if you can find it for I don't even know what it's going for now. I should probably look that up, but if it's worth any money. But really highly recommend this series. And it's only a few short issues. So issue number one, show me that awesome artwork a little closer. Two, three, and four. That's awesome. And then this one, of course, who could ever deny this series? This is just amazing. Frankenstein Alive Alive, the so-called sequel to the Marvel printed Mary Shelley's Frankenstein that was illustrated by Bernie Wrightson. So we have the Frankenstein Alive Alive here, issues 1 to 3. Beautiful artwork, great storytelling, I think. Oh, just amazing artwork inside. Waited so long for these issues when they were coming out, so you know, so much time in between each one, but they were really, really good. Kind of well worth the wait for sure. And issue number 3. Mary Shelley's Frankenstein is the Frankenstein I love. I do not like like the movie Frankenstein, you know, the bad fire. That's not the Frankenstein I like. Mary Shelley's, if you read the novel, that is the Frankenstein monster that I enjoy. Okay, a few of these. These are interesting because I'm a Nintendo fan. I'm also a Zelda fan, big one. I gotta find one more issue of these, but this is produced by Valiant. Back in the day, this is the Legend of Zelda comics from the Nintendo Comic System. And who showed off this one issue just a little while ago? I saw, I think it was Gamester81. And yeah, he showed it, and I have, I think he just had that one issue, but I have a few more here. So this is issue number 1 of 5. And I think there was some second prints as well too, so yeah, a second printing, because there's 90, and I think there was a series, I think it was exactly the same, but reprinted in 91. So issue 1, and I'm missing issue number 2, that's the one I gotta get if I can find it for cheap. Here's issue number 3, and the art based on the cartoon series that went along with the Super Mario Brothers show, which I don't have the Super Mario Brothers show, but I have the DVDs for the Legend of Zelda TV show. Here's issue number 5. Oh, showing a little bit out of order. Here's number 4. And then number 5. Okay, and the next series I'm going to show you here is Haunt. A little story about this one that just frustrates me a bit. It was a good series. I liked it. It was about kind of a brother who was a kind of a special ops government agent, and he died. His brother was a priest at the time, at the beginning of this, and he comes into contact with his dead brother. They come together to create this character, Haunt. Really interesting. It happens in, of course, you know, it's in an Image comic. It actually happens within the Image universe, and is ends up being connected to the Spawn series in a little way. But at the end of the series, it basically just stopped, ended. You didn't know what was happening with it. Again, this is another series where Image, they have never answered for, never given any, you know, clue what's happening more of this. They gave some hints in some later Spawn comics after, you know, the character being gone for a long time. In some Spawn comics, it was hinted that the character was coming back a few times and then never has since. So I don't know what's going on with this series. Is if any of you guys are into this series and know more about if this character is ever coming back, really, or what or why they haven't, just let me know. But here we go. I'll show you what I got for the collection. So here's Haunt, issue number 1. This is the variant cover. It's got the gold foil title there. So it's pretty cool. So McFarlane and Kirkman, Otley, Capullo, like a lot of great writers, artists on this book. It was pretty cool. So that's number 1, like I say, that's a variant. Here's the regular one, and what is that? Just Ryan Otley cover. Issue number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, let's see, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, I think this is where they started changing artists. I didn't like the artist as much, but the story was still pretty good. 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, and 28. So again, like I say, that's where they ended it. Never gave us any information besides a couple of hints in one Spawn comic, and even the brother who was the priest came back in one Spawn comic and told Spawn, not the Al Simon Spawn, I think it was the other Spawn, told him, you know, we're back. Just flat out said it, we're back. Major, you know, clue, hint that he's coming back and probably crossing over with Spawn comics, and hasn't yet, so crazy. Okay, and here's the final series I'm going to show you. The well-loved series, Saga, is really amazing. I was glad I got able to, you know, pick it up, you know, on the ground level there, starting with issue number one, because, I mean, the prices have definitely skyrocketed on most of these books. What do you guys think? If you're still reading this, do you like it? Do you think there's still value in this book, you know, in the series anyways? Or are you kind of coming to the end of your, you know, reading of this or whatever? Give me your guys' thoughts on that, but let's go through it quick. Just to let you guys know, you see here, this is starting with issue number 3. I do have issues number 1, signed by Fiona Staples, and issue number 2, signed and with a little bit of art on it from Fiona. Had some other issues, number 1, a couple of them with some art from Fiona, but I sold those quite a while ago, and I have them put away in my more expensive box that I've shown you guys before and might show you again later on at the end of this whole entire haul. But so just to let you know that I have them all. Let's start off here with chapter number 3, and I'll just go through them. Like I say, I got the numbers right from 1 right to current. Some of the current issues are, I'll show in a stack later on with some of my current books, but for now, this is what's in this box that I'll show you. So I'll just go through them. Don't even need to tell you the numbers because it starts with 3 and carry on from there. And the last one here, issue number 39. And like I say, I got the other ones current up to 41. Again, they're in a different pile. I'll show you guys later. But that's that. Let me guys know what your thoughts are. Comments and questions below. Hit the likes button. Comment Okay, and so that's it, you guys. Those are all my Saga comics. All that were everything that was in this image box. Next up, what I'm going to show you, probably something I have on the box. It's listed as the Infinity Gauntlet, but also has some other series in it as well too, but mostly Infinity Gauntlet related books. So that's about that, you guys. Leave your comments and questions below. Hit the thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't. Talk to y'all later. Bye.